In a world where the boundaries between the human mind and artificial intelligence blur, we embark on an extraordinary journey. A journey to explore how AI is not just mimicking, but merging with the human brain. Welcome to the frontier of imagination. Today, we'll discuss a number of fascinating projects that have an impact on, or in some cases, directly affect the human brain. How would you feel about deciding how your dream ends and what role you play in it? I'm talking about a real-life inception. Yes, it's insane. We'll discuss this in the later part of the video. We'll also talk about how living brain cells are being used to listen in on conversations using AI. In the future, we can possibly build a super brain computer that powers machines. If you're ready to have your mind blown, then so am I. Let's dive in right away. We'll kick things off with interesting research on brain-controlled robots. Just like Magneto can levitate metal, so can you control robots with your mind. Stanford University announced its brain robot interface called NOIR, which enables humans to control robots for everyday tasks using brain signals. This system utilizes electroencephalography, or EEG, to decode human intentions, allowing users to command robots to perform a wide range of household activities, including cooking, cleaning, and personal care, through thought alone. In simple terms, this works by converting the brain signals into recorded waves. The waves represent numbers, which are then used to train a machine learning model to predict what a person wants to do. The most popular brain-to-device product out there is Neuralink's brain chip, which recently had its first human procedure in January. Elon Musk announced the company's first product, called Telepathy, which can connect the brain to phones or computers. Neuralink is different in several ways from NOIR, including the brain device itself. Neuralink uses a minimally invasive method to implant the chip they call Link into the brain. Stanford's NOIR requires no surgery and uses electrodes attached to one's head. This non-invasive method is not as strong as the invasive type, but it is definitely safer than any brain surgery. NOIR from Stanford has been tested successfully in real-world scenarios, demonstrating its potential to significantly improve the quality of life, especially for individuals with disabilities, by offering greater independence in daily activities. Obviously, with any technology, things can go wrong, and the team put measures in place to avoid a robot reading the wrong signal and performing actions that are not intended. In a future where we have more complex robots, including humanoids, you can see how people will use them as extensions of themselves. Like in the movie Surrogates, that was the first thought that came to mind when I read the research paper. Our world has become a safer place. If you thought brain-to-robot connection was insane, wait till you hear about AI made from living human brain cells that performs speech processing. This next technology is a biocomputer that consists of living brain cells that have learned to recognize the voice of an individual from hundreds of sound clips. Researchers at Indiana University call the system BrainWare. These balls of human brain cells, or brain organoids, grown in the lab from stem cells into lumps of nerve cells, are a few millimeters wide. They contain up to 100 million nerve cells and are placed atop a microelectrode array. This setup allows the organoids to receive electrical signals and process information that is finally passed through an AI model. It's a new form of AI that could potentially operate with far less energy than traditional silicon chips. The human brain has about 100 billion neurons, similar to several AI models, but with much lower energy requirements. The compute energy from chips, however, allows computers to be very good at certain tasks that humans certainly can't do, like reading the entire internet. Scientists have been trying to build computers based on advanced biological systems for decades, The BrainWear project is still in its proof-of-concept stage, but it represents a significant step towards integrating biological systems with artificial intelligence for more efficient computing solutions. A few months prior, the team used the same setup to solve mathematical equations. And 2 years earlier than that, in 2021, an Australian lab used brain cells in a dish to learn to play Pong. The brain has millions of years of evolutionary advantage over chips in terms of complexity. This could be another way of approaching computer brain systems. Who knows what the future holds? The lab-grown brain cells take about 2 to 3 months to mature, and they have to be kept fresh and alive all the time. There are other important issues that have to be addressed in the future for a system like BrainWear to become a reality. But imagine an entire room filled with the mega brain that has more power than a single human brain. Imagine the possibilities, but also the frightening nature of such technology.
The human neurons growing on microchips.
You have these layers and you lay them so you can actually keep stacking them. So you could grow a brain the size of a room.
Growing neurons on top of silicon chips and connecting them to digital systems.
So the neurons live in there at the moment.
These are what our chips look like. So in here, there's approximately a million cells.
BrainWear is not the only brain-inspired computer. A team of researchers also developed a groundbreaking synaptic transistor that mimics the human brain's functionality, operating at room temperature and demonstrating significant energy efficiency. This device is capable of higher level processing and storage of information simultaneously, just like the human brain. The synaptic transistor can operate about 1,000 times faster than the response times observed in biological synapses. Unlike previous attempts at creating devices that required cryogenic temperatures, this new transistor is stable at room temperature, operates at fast speeds, consumes minimal energy, and, get this, retains information even when power is removed. The transistor uses special NOIR design, making it 100 times more power efficient and able to store up to 100 times more information than traditional transistors. This can be used to handle intensive data processing that will be too much for traditional silicon-based chips. Chips have really come a long way and have taken us very far in this new era of deep learning and AI. There are several efforts on other fronts to find alternatives to these chips that can handle data much better and faster. Probably the most popular example among this list is quantum computing, which we've discussed several times on this channel. Before we get to our final and probably the most intriguing part of this video, a breakthrough worth mentioning is DeepMind's AlphaFold model, which recently identified hundreds of thousands of potential new psychedelic molecules for a new set of antidepressant drugs. We've discussed AlphaFold a few times across the channel. The AI tool can predict protein structures in minutes, which otherwise will take humans years and years of research. This achievement further demonstrates AlphaFold's ability to help discover new drugs, and we're beginning to see more examples of this. Congrats to the DeepMind team for continuing this effort in a very important industry. Our final AI product is a dream curator. I know that sounds confusing, but let me explain. Imagine a world where you can dive into the depths of your subconscious mind while still having control. Prophetic is working on an AI neurotech wearable called the Halo that can stabilize and control your dreams. In other words, they are trying to make Inception a reality. The Halo uses their Morpheus 1 model, which they claim to be the world's first multimodal generative ultrasonic transformer, meaning that instead of words or sentences, Morpheus understands brain states and can generate ultrasonic holograms to guide you into a lucid dream state. The model has 103 million parameters. However, I suspect later iterations might be bigger in order to produce a more powerful model. The company says Morpheus will be available for beta users in spring 2024, and you can make a deposit of $100 on their website, which is fully refundable. The product is estimated to cost around $2,000 for now. So let's talk more about what the product is actually offering. Lucid dreams are where you become aware you're dreaming, offering a unique state for objective observation of self-awareness, cognition, and sensory perception. I'm sure some of you have had the experience where all of a sudden you get a sense that you may be in a dream. Sometimes you're able to manipulate certain aspects of the dream, but it's all very limited. The company believes this approach can also help answer the most difficult questions about consciousness by providing a sandbox for creativity, metaphysical exploration, and recreational experiences beyond the bounds of physics. From solving complex problems to flying through dreamscapes, the possibilities are as limitless as your imagination. Here's how Morpheus One actually works. It collects EEG through the halo to understand where brain signals are firing and when the dreamer has entered REM sleep. It also uses ultrasound data to stabilize and induce the brain during the dream state. To run the models on the app, Halo has a battery that lasts the night and sends data over Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. The ultimate goal of the company is to offer a pathway to a general theory of consciousness by affecting the dream state of a person. This is a very complex problem, and who knows if prophetic AI can pull it off. Some of the issues to watch out for are how accurate the model is and what possible side effects may arise from long-term wearing of the Halo. What do you think about Morpheus One? Are you open to trying the Halo for a few nights? I'll leave the website link in the description below. We've discussed a few projects around AI and the brain from different perspectives. Whether it's building a super organic brain that can replace chips, or chips that have neuromorphic structures to accelerate processing. It's all very exciting. We cover very exciting AI research across the channel, so don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Until the next video, it's goodbye.